Hello friends, today we will discuss about routine laparoscopic instruments. We will not include special instruments like used in gynae or coagulation instruments or advanced instruments. These are just routine laparoscopic instruments that we use for normal laparoscopic surgeries. So these are a few examples, like the one that we have on this edge is little longer. So this is used in usually the bariatric surgeries or for those patients who are very obese. The in-between is one what is being used routinely, and this one is for pediatric surgeries or for mini laparoscopic surgeries. The length of a routine laparoscopic instrument, it's being measured by the length of the shaft, like from here till here, and this varies somewhere around 33 to 37 centimeters, whereas the smaller instruments for pediatric use, they are less than 30 centimeters, and the longer instruments are usually more than 40 centimeters, like this one here is around 42, and this can go up to 45 centimeters. The width of the instruments, these two are 5 millimeters and this one is around 3 mm. So the mini laparoscopic or pediatric instruments are usually up to 3 mm or less. So now we have opened one of the instruments. You can see these are the three common parts. So this is the handle. This is the outer sheath, which is insulated. It's black in color and it protects the spread of current to the adjacent organs. And this is the insert. So the insert has a specific tip. These tips are meant for different functions, like this one here is so-called a Maryland forceps, and we need to insert this into the sheath. So that is why this is known as the insert part and this is the sheath part. The metallic part will conduct electric current, but this insulated part will not. So this should shield your adjacent parts or the adjacent organs so as to avoid any inadvertent injury or electric current to those things. And then we need to insert the handle. So the insertion can vary from model to model. Like in this one, we need to open the grips of the handle and then insert it, push it, and then close this grip. That engages the instrument and it gets locked here. So now it is ready to use. This thing is for rotation. So when you're grasping, you can use this for rotating the instrument to get a proper angle on your tissue. This part here is for attachment of the electric monopolar cautery cable. So you can attach your monopolar cable over here and then start conducting the monopolar cautery. This is the release button, so once you press it, this is going to disengage and you can then clean it, and then after cleaning, you can put it back. So for cleaning, you must disengage. You must open the insert also, like this, just rotate it here, and then this will come out. And once it's properly disassembled, you must disassemble the instrument properly like this before you clean it, because otherwise you are not able to clean the inner parts. The debris will lie here, it won't get sterilized well, and slowly it will degrade the instrument also. So you must disengage, open it fully, and then only clean it. Always check this insulation sheath after all uses and even before using the instrument, so that you do not cause any injury if there is any break in the insulation. If there is a break, you can change this particular part and you can reuse the insert as well as the handle, and you can just change the sheath. So this is a different type of a handle, which has a locking mechanism over here, so you can lock it and it will retain the position. But then this part is also different. So as you can see, there is no clickable mechanism over here, so we need to rotate it, or this joint, this part will come out, and then you can open the grip and disengage it over here, and then this will come out. So again, this part can be taken out, this insert can be removed. This is how you can disengage, disassemble this whole instrument, wash it well, and then again reassemble. So again, you just insert it over here. This has a screw, so you just tighten it, and then place this part over here, engage it over here, and then you tighten it. So rest of the parts are similar. This is the shaft, this is the tip of the instrument, this part is for rotation, this is for monopolar cautery, these are the grips. So now we'll go through some of the common types of tips that we use. The tips means the tip of the instrument by which we define the instrument also. So various kinds of tips are designed for various kinds of properties of the tissue and parts of the surgeries. Like here we have bowel grasper. So this one is very broad and has penetrations. So this is used for holding the bowel, and this is atraumatic. It doesn't mean it cannot cause a trauma, you just have to be gentle with the tissue, and because of the broad surface and bigger size, this helps in preventing the trauma to the tissue. This one is a grasper. Usually we use it in our left hand when we're doing a surgery to hold the tissues. It is again a little less traumatic, has a blunt tip, So as when you're inserting, you do not injure a tissue that gets stricken with this, and it is commonly used to hold the tissues with your left hand of the surgeon. This one is known as the Maryland. It's a curved dissector. It has a pointed tip, not a very sharp tip, blunt tip, but it curves as we go towards the tip. So this one is usually used in the right hand of the surgeon, and it can be used during suturing in the left hand also when you're using a needle holder in your right hand. So this one is one of the most commonly used dissectors in laparoscopic surgery with the right hand of the surgeon. So the beauty is that tapering tip, the fine dissection is possible. You can go close to the tissues, then use it to dissect. You can enter the crevices, you can dissect the structures like going around a cystic artery or a vessel, and that way it helps a lot during surgery. So this one is a laparoscopic Babcock's forceps, where you have a grasping tip and a hollow face before that, so that when you're holding a tissue, you can hold the tissue between the tip and the shaft, so that like you are holding an appendix, it can come between this hollow part so that you do not injure it and you are just encircling it. So this is like an open Babcock's forceps. You can use it for delicate structures where you want a minimal trauma. This is a tooth forceps which has sharp teeth at its tip. So this is used to hold tougher structures or to hold a specimen, like if you are doing a laparoscopic cholecystectomy, you can hold the gallbladder with this, because even if it is traumatic, the gallbladder is going to come out. So this is for a very secure grip, and when you have to retract the tissues, you can hold it here. It usually has a locking mechanism also. You can hold, then lock, and then push it so that it stays there and doesn't come out, because a good amount of force is required to keep the tissue static during surgery. So this one is a routine laparoscopic scissors. It's a curved scissor, and usually it is used for dissection. You can cut the tissues, do edusolysis and other things. Even sutures can be cut with this scissors, but usually we can have a hooked scissor specially designed for suture cutting. This one here is a hooked scissor, where its tip is like a hook. You can engage your suture and then cut it. It prevents the slippage of the suture outside this, and since the tips are blunt, so it also prevents the injury to a structure or an organ if it hits the organ like this. That is why it is more useful to cut the sutures and more safe also. So these are two commonly used instruments for laparoscopic surgery, but these do not have a grip as we showed in the other instruments. This one is a hook where you have a grip at the tip where you can hold it. It's like a handle, and you have an area to insert your monopolar cautery here, an electrode. This is the shaft, insulated one, and this is the tip. So since this tip is hook shaped, so that is why it is known as a hook. The hook has a tip over here and an elbow over here. So if you need a very fine dissection or you need to give a nick, you can use the tip, and otherwise you can use the elbow or the shaft here to give more coagulation effect, because this has much more surface area. So this can be used to coagulate the tissues, and the tip can be used to cut. Even the elbow can be used for in-between action. This one has almost a similar structure, a grip at the back with attachment for electrode, a shaft, insulated one, and then it has a tip which is of a spatula shaped. So spatula means that this has a larger surface area. It does not have a pointed edge like the hook, and this is mostly used for coagulation, but the tip or the edge of the spatula can also be used for dissection. Because if you just touch the edge, it will have more cutting effect, and if you use the broad surface area of the spatula, that will have a more coagulation effect. So for hemostasis, we use the broader surface, and for dissection, we use the edge of the spatula. This part here, the white part, is basically a ceramic. So this is to prevent melting of this sheath as the heat is generated during surgeries. So this ceramic part helps for the preservation of the sheath, and it's also an insulator, so that is how it helps in the surgery and prolonging the life of the instrument. We'll discuss about laparoscopic bipolar instruments. So we have broadly two kinds. One is a simple bipolar instrument, and this one is an advanced version of a bipolar instrument. So let us see what are the different features, how to use them, what are the benefits, and how you can get the best out of your instruments. We'll start with a routine bipolar instrument like this one. If you compare, this one has a single attachment over here where you can attach your monopolar cable, which has only one electrode, and the other electrode is basically placed behind the patient in a way of a patient pad which completes the circuit. So the current travels from the tip of the instrument through the pad and actually travels through the whole body's tissue, and then it's returned back to the machine, and that is how the circuit completes. Whereas if you see in this bipolar instrument, this has two electrodes, one on this side and one on this side. Similarly, the cable has two electrodes. So once you engage it here, it has one on this side and one on this side, and at the other end of the cable we have two leads. So these both will go into their receptacles into the bipolar machine. So most of the common cautery machines, they have monopolar as well as the bipolar mode. So once you switch to bipolar mode, you can activate the bipolar instrument. So what happens once you start using the instrument, its tip also has two different jaws. So if you look close, this one has a plastic insert so that it stays different from the other jaw. So these two jaws are not connected metallically by themselves like in a routine instrument. So if you see this one, it doesn't have a plastic component at its tip. So whatever current flows through one jaw, it also flows through the other jaw. Whereas this one, both the jaws, they are being electrically shielded. The current that flows from this goes to the other jaw only once it crosses through the tissue that's in between. So otherwise there won't be any circuit completion. This won't fire. So how do we use this? So suppose this is your tissue. You hold the tissue between the two jaws of the instrument, close it so that both the jaws are touching the tissue that is to be coagulated. Then you activate this. So this has to be activated only and only once the tissue that has to be coagulated is in between both the jaws. Unless both the jaws are touching the tissue, this won't activate and this won't result in any coagulation. So benefit of the bipolar device is that the current is not flowing throughout the body of the patient. It's just flowing through the tissue that is to be coagulated, and hence it is safe for patients, especially those who have cardiac pacemakers or those who have cardiac issues, so that it doesn't flow through a big chunk of tissue in the patient's body. The coagulation capacity of the bipolar also is little higher than the monopolar devices, and this becomes even higher with specialized intelligent devices like this one we have. It's from Covadian, sold by the name of LigaSure, and this one actually scans the resistance of the tissue and gives a feedback to the machine hundreds of times or maybe thousands of times per second, so that the amount of current flowing through the instrument, it varies as per the resistance of the tissue. So as soon as the machine realizes that the coagulation is complete, it gives you a feedback in the form of a sound, and then you can stop using the instrument. So that indicates that now the coagulation is complete and you can fire it. So this device has a bipolar jaws in the front as with a routine device. Once you close it, this gets closed, and it has a button at the end. So if you take it further, this button will be pressed and it gets activated. And once the coagulation cycle is complete, you can press this button over here so that the blade gets fired. So it has a blade, a cutting blade between these jaws. So once it is done, the coagulation is complete. So we can fire it from over here, and then the tissue gets disconnected, it's cut, and then you open the jaws and proceed. So the advantage of having such kind of devices is that you can coagulate even up to vessels which are 7 millimeters in diameter. It gives you a better control of the tissue. The bleeding is less, the hemostasis is much better. The tips also, you see the tip is quite blunt and it's with the shape of a Maryland, it's curved, and it helps you in dissection as well as in coagulation and achieving the hemostasis as you proceed. The advantage of having a feedback or an advanced system like this is that the hemostasis can be better. They can coagulate even higher vessels, as said, up to 7 millimeters. And because of the feedback mechanism, the tissue is not charred excessively. So this is going to stop as soon as you achieve the desired effect. We hope the video was useful. We have a lot of such videos on our channel, and we hope keep finding them interesting. And for that, you kindly consider to like, share, and subscribe our channel. Thank you.